Yo, what's good? It's been a minute. I'll take off my glasses. It's been a minute. My name is Danny. Pronouns are he and him. And I just love cigars, man. Love cigars. So if you want to send me some, I'll gladly accept. Nah, I'm only kidding. But anyways, welcome. So this is going to be short, man. You know, happy Pride. I hope y'all enjoyed Pride Month. Yesterday, I went to St. Pete. It was so hot. Way too humid. To me, it's too much. But anyways, today I'm watching the... Today is my great state of New York is having theirs. I think other places, San Francisco and Chicago and things like that. One day I would like to go to the one in San Francisco. I really love California. I love their weather. I just like California. Anyways, listen, this is going to be a short video, right? So this is a question, man. And to all my trans folks, right? Do you find your friends, and I mean like cisgender people in your life, right? When you like... I don't know, you tell them something about like, lately I've been, coughing a lot. Or lately I've been, like for instance, right, since December, I've had issues sleeping. Like if I sleep 5 hours, that's a lot, you know. I think last night I had a good sleep. but I don't sleep like all night through, you know. Like I'll be up, sleep, and then wake up. And it takes me a minute to sleep. So, do you find your cis friends automatically say, do you think it's your testosterone? everything, you know, it's I used to like to drink such as, nah, you know what? I don't have the taste for it. I don't like it. It don't taste the same. Do you think testosterone changed your taste bits? They forget that. I laugh at them. I laugh that internally, to tell you the truth, I'm like, oh, you know how dumb you sound? You sound very dumb. But I say that internal. I don't say it verbally. I just stare. I just have this blank stare like, and then I go, no. No, it has nothing to do with testosterone. Testosterone, yes, has some changes, physical and some other changes, of course, you know. But I'm on the fifth floor. I'm already 50. So you got to understand that you start changing. Not only with testosterone, you know, you change as a person because you're getting older, you know. And I'm not saying every 50-year-old is having a hard time sleeping. Right? You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying that me, from out of nowhere, I can't sleep. I don't have no idea, you know? And things like that. It's just like when I started realizing that I needed reading glasses. That came out of nowhere. I swear to God. Like one day I was good, and then the next day I went out to... I'll always remember I was out dinner at that time with my girlfriend, my ex now. One of my exes. But anyways, and I'm looking at the menu, and I'm like, why? In my mind, I'm saying, why can I not see? Like, I'm putting the menu like real close. I'm squinting and I'm looking. Like, I'm trying to clean my eyes, like, what that came out of nowhere, right? No one's telling you, no one's tapping you on your shoulder and tell you, hey, but around, you know, in the 40s, you might start needing reading glasses, right? Because my mom, she's in her, you know, in her 70s, she don't need no reading glasses. Sometimes I have to give her and tell her, read me that, I can't see it, right? So it's just part of you aging. You got to remember that. You can't blame testosterone for everything. I got this mole. What you think it is? Maybe it's your testosterone? No. Maybe I need to go to a doctor. It could be cancerous. I don't know. Like, you know, like... Oh, it kills me, man. don't know, probably this video is really petty and you're like, what the fuck is this guy talking about? But it's true, cis people will come out with the most weirdest shit. They'll be like, yo, they... Oh my goodness gracious, I can't, you know? They're funny, very funny. But anyway, so guys, I made it short. If you have any questions, anything, you can always ask. Negative comments, I think I only answered one here. I usually don't, and it's because they call me a groomer. And that kind of set me off, and so I responded with a lengthy comment, and then I was like, I shouldn't. I try not to comment to negative stuff, and it's so, I think it's ridiculous. We're in 2023, and there's proven facts of who are the real groomers, which are cis males, priests, all them. That's been proven. That's a fact. They're the groomers. Pedophiles. Disgusting people. But we still attacking the transgender community. We have the audacity to put that word pedophile and trans. And they don't even go together. Don't go, not even close. That belongs to you cis people. Belongs to you cis people. So anyways, you can ask questions. I'll gladly, I ignore all negative comments. I don't bring myself to that, lower my standards and lower myself to that. But happy Pride, man. Happy Pride. If you in New York, man, I love my state. It's just after a deployment, I don't know, I came back and I don't do well with too much people. Crowd, so I really don't do prize like I used to, and things to that. But anyways, enjoy your day, stay strong, and everything's gonna be all right. I'm gonna enjoy my cigar, chill, and have a good one.